Welcome to this lesson from the Urban Penguin. My name is Andrew Mallett, and today we're going to look at some really cool stuff using snippets and mapping keys within VI. As always, you can catch up on these videos on the Urban Penguin. You can follow me on Twitter at the Urban Penguin and on Facebook, the Urban Penguin. And as an unadulterated plug, if you're interested in Citrix, my Access Gateway book is now out. So I think the saying is when in Rome, do as the Romans do. And I think when we're using Vi or Vim as our text editor, we should do what the Linux gurus do. So let's look at some of the power that we have within our text editor. So one of the things we might do when we're creating our scripts is create a little snippet library. So we can create templates and then we'll import those templates into new script files. We look at executing programs such as date within Vi, so it's very easy then to put date and timestamps in our file. Creating shortcuts and mapping keys to actions, and then of course making these settings permanent by adding them to our .vimrc file. So the first thing we're going to look at is snippets, or just creating your own code library. I've created a directory in my home directory called snippets. So if we go through to that, I haven't got too much in here, I've just got one file, but I've just called this file if. I might create another one called case. So all this is going to be, when we look at it, if we cat out the file if, is then just a sample if statement. I'll put a little bit of documentation just to remind myself that if I'm testing for numerical values, then I'm going to use the curled braces. I use the square braces if I'm testing then for text values. And then a very simple sample usage. Obviously I'm not doing any test condition, but we can see that I've built that up with square brackets, so that would be testing for strings. So in itself, I can build up a whole load of little samples, however I find them useful. Then when I go back into my previous directory, so going back into my bin directory, if I want to now create a script, then I can go through and vi-o2.sh. So we'll create a new and empty file. So of course we might put in things like the hash bin, the bin bash. So if we go through and hit in insert and then hash bang slash bin slash bash. Now for whatever reason we might want an if statement. Just escape just to take me back to the normal mode in Vi. Go into my command mode by hitting the colon, and then I'm going to read from my home directory in the snippets directory, and I can use tab completion, and I'm going to read in the file if. So now we've brought the code snippet in, so now of course then I can go through and edit the if statement, and of course, as you can see, I've put in my little remarks, so I can see any help that I might normally want when I'm struggling putting in if statements. So build up your own library and then import them. To read in a file, remember we just go into our command mode, so it's going to be then escape colon R and then the pass through to the snippet to read in. Now the next thing to look at is that I might want to go through and say something like, you know, I edited this file, or the file was created on a certain date and time. So I can go through, hit my insert, yeah, type whatever text I need, so created on. And of course I could type the date, but rather than typing the date, I could use the date function. So again, I jump out. I still read in, but now I'm going to read in exclamation mark. So I'm going to read the output of a command. And then I'm going to, let's say, just run the date command. And then it puts the whole date and time in underneath the line that I was on. If I move up to the line above and then hit a capital or uppercase J, just joins those two lines together. So that's okay, but probably I don't want the full date and time values in like that, so I might just want the date versions. So of course we have to understand a little bit of how date works. For the moment, let's just go through and delete that line. So we'll do a DD, delete that line. We can jump out and save that file. If I just go date by itself, then that's the output that I saw. If I want a date formatted with just the ordinary date, but let's say in my locale setting, so the day first, then the month, and then the year. So I'm in the UK, of course, if you're in the US, you'll be looking at the month first and then the day. But if I go date plus percent X, we then get just the date format. So that's quite nice in itself. So I don't have all of the time element. We can also use that anywhere, so long as your locale is set correctly, then we will get the date in that format. Just to show you, if I go through and echo out my $lang at the moment, we can see that is ENGB. If I go through and change that, so if I go lang equals EN underscore US, and now run the date plus percent X, we can see it swapped the day and the month. So as long as you've got your environment variables that are set up correctly, it's going to show you the date in the correct format for you. We're not looking at anything that runs when we open up the document when we put this in. It is just going to be when you run the command, we're going to put in the date stamp. So we don't have to worry about it changing if somebody opens it up in another country. So let's just reverse my language setting, put it back to GB. So we've got it back now set correctly. Now the problem is, though, when I go through and run my date command, is that the percent character is picked up in VI, and that actually means the file name, so it has a special meaning. So I have to escape that character when I run it from within VI. Let's go back then and edit the file. Not worry about my text saying it was edited, we'll just look at the date at the moment. So escape, colon, read in, then the date command. And then we'll just go through plus escape the percent X, close out my quotes. And now we've got that then set up nicely. Now, yeah, that's kind of okay, but when we're looking at that, we think, well, it's just as easy to type it. I would still argue that at least this is putting it in a consistent format, whereas obviously if we're typing it, sometimes we might just go and put the 7th, and we might put Feb instead of 02, so this way it's going in consistent. But I do accept that, of course, there are issues with having to type all of this and get it correct. So we can look at mapping keys. If I escape and then just delete this line for the moment, what we really want to do, especially if we want to go through and put in that text and then we want to write the line of text, once we've written the line of text, we want to go back into our ordinary mode and then the command mode, and then call up the date command. We want to go up one line and join the two lines together. So if we go back and look at what we really need to achieve, we want to go through and insert a line of text. So we can go through here, type in whatever we want. This was created on, hit escape, run our command mode, so then R, exclamation mark, date, carriage return, up one line, capital J. So that's really what we want to put as a macro behind a key. So if we look at how we're going to do that, we're going to our command mode, and then we can type map. So the word map by itself means it's operating from the ordinary mode rather than insert mode. If I go map exclamation mark, then map exclamation mark would be whilst I'm in insert. We can then choose the key that we want to map. So I'm going to choose, let's say, the F2 key. Normally, we don't want to use the F1 key because that's, well, I would say reserved for help, but it's normally used for help. We want to go into insert mode. We're then going to write, this file was created on. So there's the lead-in line. We then hit escape, so we go out of our edit mode. We go into our command mode and run the date command. So our date command, and then we want to escape. Once we've done the escape, we want to go to the line above, so that, you know, this file was created on, because when we run the date command, it's always going to insert on a new line. So we go K, capital J then joins this file was created to the line below it, the date line, and that's what we want. So let's go through and run that. We'll just put an empty line here. Now when we go through and run this, we just hit the F2 command, and then we've got it set. So this file was created on the 7th of February 2013. So that's all well and good, but I say, yeah, that is an awful lot of typing, so we're not going to do that every time. So let's jump out. Look at our vimrc file, so cd into the home directory, vi.vimrc. It may not exist, so mine does, but it's just empty. So if we hit insert, so yeah, we run the map command. Whichever key that we want to map, so with this we're going to say like that F2 key. Put in the text that we want. So again, especially if I'm looking at creating script files frequently, well, maybe I want to put in a couple of function keys. So the first thing I'm going to do is I to insert text and put in my hash bling. So then we go through hash. That's /bin/bash. Jump out of editing. We'll map the F3 key. So this will be where we want to go. So again, we can go through and say, well, we might even go to this. So insert a new line below. Put in our comment. This file was created on, escape, colon, read, exclamation mark, date, open up our arguments, plus escape, percent x, close all of that out, escape, and then we're going to run the K and J to join the two lines together. So it's a lowercase K, an uppercase J, and then jump out of this and save it. Now let's say if we go in and create a new file, so bash03.sh, I can hit my F2 command, my F3 command. So it's as simple as that. Then of course I can go through and start reading in my snippets. So all we're looking at here is how we can make the Vi text editor more usable to ourselves. So we looked at creating snippets, how we can execute and map shortcut keys to codes, and then making those settings permanent within our .vmrc. I think when you start looking at this, you do realize why people are so enthusiastic about Vi and Vim. And again, I think all of these things become quite simple encouragements to start practicing with Vi and using it. But thank you, and I'll see you back soon.